Once upon a time in the ancient land of China, there lived a young monk named Shen. He resided in a secluded monastery high up in the mountains. The monastery was a place of peace and tranquility, surrounded by lush green forests and flowing rivers. The air was pure, and the sound of birdsong filled the valley. Shen had joined the monastery as a child, seeking refuge from the harsh realities of the world. He had always been a quiet and introspective boy, and the monastery provided him with the perfect environment to contemplate the deeper mysteries of life. The monks who lived in the monastery were followers of a unique spiritual path. Their teachings emphasized the importance of living selflessly and cultivating inner peace. They believed that by letting go of personal desires and attachments, they could transcend the suffering of the world and attain enlightenment. Shen had been taught these principles since he was a young boy. He had always been eager to learn and had taken to heart the teachings of his wise and patient teachers. However, as he grew older, Shen began to feel a growing sense of unease. He found it difficult to reconcile the teachings of the monastery with his own feelings and desires. He longed for more than just inner peace and detachment from the world. He wanted to experience life, to feel the warmth of friendship, and the love of a companion. Shen knew that these desires were not in line with the path he had chosen. But he couldn't shake the feeling that there was more to life than what he had been taught. His confusion led him to question the validity of the teachings and the wisdom of his mentors. He became increasingly distant and withdrawn, spending more and more time alone in his small, sparse room. One day, while deep in thought, Shen was approached by an elderly monk named Lao. Lao had been observing Shen's struggles and had grown concerned for the young monk's well-being. He decided to share with Shen a story that had been passed down through generations of monks at the monastery. The story was about a wise and powerful dragon that lived at the summit of a nearby mountain. It was said that the dragon possessed the ability to grant a person's deepest desire. However, the journey to the dragon's lair was treacherous, and few had ever dared to attempt it. Lao suggested that Shen should seek out the dragon and ask for guidance in his quest for understanding. Shen was intrigued by the story, and he saw it as an opportunity to find the answers he so desperately sought. He decided to embark on the perilous journey to the dragon's lair. He packed a small bag with only the bare necessities and set off into the wilderness. The journey was long and arduous. Shen faced many challenges along the way, including treacherous mountain paths, raging rivers, and the ever-present threat of wild animals. But he remained undeterred, driven by the hope that the dragon could help him find the answers he sought. After many days of travel, Shen finally arrived at the base of the mountain where the dragon was said to reside. He began his ascent, each step becoming more difficult than the last, as the air grew thinner and the wind howled around him. Just as he was beginning to doubt his own strength, Shen caught a glimpse of the dragon's lair, nestled among the clouds. With renewed determination, he pushed onward, finally reaching the entrance to the dragon's home. As Shen entered the lair, he was awestruck by the sight that greeted him. The dragon was magnificent, its scales shimmering with an otherworldly glow. It regarded Shen with a wise and knowing gaze, and Shen could sense the immense power that lay within the creature. He bowed before the dragon and humbly asked for its guidance in his quest for understanding. The dragon, seemingly amused by Shen's request, agreed to help him, but only if Shen could prove himself worthy. It posed a series of challenges for the young monk to overcome, each more difficult than the last. Shen faced each challenge with courage and determination, drawing upon the skills he had learned at the monastery. He crossed a chasm on a narrow, swaying rope bridge. He scaled a sheer cliff face using only his bare hands and feet. And he navigated a labyrinth filled with traps and pitfalls, relying on his intuition to guide him through. Finally, exhausted and battered, Shen stood before the dragon once more. The dragon, impressed by Shen's resilience and tenacity, agreed to grant him the guidance he sought. It told Shen that the path to true understanding lay in balancing the teachings of the monastery with the experiences and emotions of the world. It explained that one could not attain true enlightenment by rejecting the world entirely. Rather, it was through engaging with the world, with all its joys and sorrows, that one could truly learn to live selflessly. The dragon reminded Shen that living selflessly did not mean denying oneself of love, friendship, or happiness. Instead, it meant using those experiences to deepen one's compassion and understanding of others. By living a life of selflessness, one could help alleviate the suffering of the world, not just through detachment, but through connection and empathy. Shen thanked the dragon for its wisdom and vowed to take its teachings to heart. He began his journey back to the monastery, filled with a newfound sense of purpose and understanding. As he traveled, he found himself drawn to the people and places he encountered along the way. He listened to their stories, shared in their joys and sorrows, and offered what help he could. He discovered that by opening himself up to the world, he was able to cultivate a deeper sense of empathy and compassion. This newfound understanding of selflessness brought Shen a sense of inner peace that had eluded him for so long. When Shen finally returned to the monastery, he was greeted with open arms by his fellow monks. They had noticed his absence and had been worried for his safety. Shen shared his experiences and the wisdom he had gained from the dragon with his fellow monks. His story inspired them to re-examine their own understanding of selflessness and the teachings of the monastery. Together, they began to explore new ways of engaging with the world, seeking to find a balance between detachment and connection. Shen's journey had not only led him to a deeper understanding of selflessness, but it also inspired those around him to seek a more compassionate and connected path. And so, the monastery's teachings evolved, incorporating the wisdom of the dragon and the experiences of the world. As for Shen, he continued to walk the path of selflessness, guided by the wisdom of the dragon and the love and friendship of those he encountered along the way. His journey had taught him that by embracing the world and all its complexities, he could truly live a selfless life and help to alleviate the suffering of others. Thank you for listening this far. I hope you enjoyed the story and get something positive out of it. Make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel if you already haven't. Have a wonderful day.